So today I'm here with the Bissell Powerforce Helix. It's just the basic Powerforce Helix model. Because you know I had the Turbo Rewind model and the Cord Rewind had problems. So I decided just to get this machine. So it has the Helix separation system, easy empty dirt container, 5 height adjustments, washable filters, a full set of tools, 23-foot cord, and a 2-year warranty. For $50, a 2-year warranty is pretty good. It says powerful suction deep cleans, washable filter. Basically, it's the same on this side. Here's more things. So it says washable filter. It's the same. It has edge-to-edge cleaning and a crevice tool and dusting brush. But that's really all that is different. Or that's all that is different on the back. Yeah. Besides, like reading it on the front. Front and back of the box say the same thing. Sometimes there's more detailed descriptions on one side or the other, but it's not. Instructions. We have these tools right here. Let's just take this piece out. Got this dusting brush right here. Let's just take it all out. Oh, it's one of these hoses. All right. Okay. Simple. Okay. Handle. Nice, comfortable handle. Again, what I'd kind of expect. Here's the wand piece. Oh, there's the crevice tool. Of course, it's covered in a whole bunch of stuff. Right, so this goes here. Yeah, right here. Right like that. Oh, the dusting brush. Let's cut the tape on this handle. Get a visitor. My cat is interested in the vacuum. He's right behind me. Oh, never mind. He just passed by. Probably gonna go eat or something. I have my ridiculously long screwdriver. I can put the screws in. Let's try and get the screw in here. Next. sit. Now I'm going to set up the main hose. Just pretty sure it just locks in place right here. Yep, that's how it goes. Lock in farther.
Nope.
Just goes in just like the other one did. This. This right there. Put this here. Grab all this cord. This is the 2191 model. All right, it's fully assembled. Let's check out the dirt tank design. So I'm gonna check out the filtration. There's a filter under here. Let's see it. I don't know how to get to it. Yeah, there's a filter down there. I can see it.
See the fiber underneath there?
There's a filter under there. But I don't know how to get to it. Maybe it's like a non-removable one? Let's see what the instructions say. Do not see anything about that secondary filter. I only see the one filter, but there is a second filter in here, and I can see it. So I wonder how you get to it. That's kind of strange. Kind of expect to be able to get to this filter, but I really want to know how I can clean that. Is there just an easy way to get to it? There's definitely a filter right here. It could be just screw right here. There is a second filter down there, because I can see it. I want to know how to clean that filter out. Right here. Oh, that's loosening it up. Okay. I just want to make sure now, and anyone who else needs to clean this filter on video. See if this comes apart before cleaning. So I want to make sure that we'll wash all the filters on my machine and make sure they know where they are, where the filters are. I sort of like to know that before I begin use. So if I need to perform any maintenance, I know how to do it instead of having to, like, say, I'm in the middle of cleaning. Oh, I ran out of, or the vacuum loses suction. I'm like, okay, why? I don't really feel like going on my phone or something at the moment. I prefer to know right then. Goodness, that's still on there. Huh. It's probably just non-removable then. Just make sure all retaining screws that could be holding that thing in place are out. Now she looks like they're still in there. Okay, it's just not a filter that needs to be maintained. I'm guessing needs to be maintained. Because there is physically no way to get this filter off. I'm not going to force it. So, nope, doesn't need to be maintained, I'm guessing. Just put the screws back in and forget about it. Looks like I did not fully screw the other one in place. This is one of the screws that you can take off. This is for accessing the hose. There you go. Now it's screwed in, I have to remember. Okay. Let's check out the dirt bin design. General dirt bin, nothing different. But I can say that even on a machine of this price, they do a good job on seals. They do a really good job on seals. Here's the filter that you do clean. It's the same as the last one, a large foam filter. As I said, same as the last one. Let's check out if the cyclonic assembly is... Oh, heck yeah, it is. Wow, that's pretty clean. That's pretty easy clean right there. That locks in place. Dirt, I'm guessing, spins around in this gray area. So it looks like it has like a several stage cyclone. So basically, the gray part's a cyclone area. The gray part from here to up into here. This and this are a cyclone. And there's this... I'm guessing that's a cyclonic thing down there. I'm not sure if that's a full out separation area, but I know it's some type of a cyclone. Cyclone of one way, or of one sort. Cyclone of some sort, you know? Trying to set up this hose correctly so it's not bent around at multiple angles. But I don't like having super sharp right angle or super sharp angles because it allows clogs. Just turn it on quickly. So I'm just really interested to see hear how loud it is. Is that a bug or a piece of fuzz? Okay, it's a piece of fuzz, not a bug. Oh god. Another spider or something I have to deal with. Clean up all this mess and be ready for the next video. Oh goodness, this has been going along for a while.